Greetings to you all, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. A special welcome to those of you that are visiting my channel for the first time. My name is Father Arthur Ndembula from the Archdiocese of Lusaka in Zambia. And of course, a special welcome back, I should say, to those of you that are coming back to this channel. Thank you very much for being here once again. As you may have read from the title, in this particular clip, I would like to talk about some things. Life is slightly different from what we've always been talking about. And particularly, I want to talk about the three major church documents that you and I, we Catholics, are supposed to have in our houses and on our shelves. Documents that we should be reading for us to understand the Catholic Church, what the Catholic Church teaches, what we do, why we do what we do, and everything that surrounds our faith. These three documents are cardinal. Of course, there are many other documents that you find in the Catholic bookshops, even on the internet, that explain our faith. You do well to read those as well, as long as they are approved by the Church. But mine is just talk about these three. The first one, the Catechism of the Catholic Church. The Catechism of the Catholic Church is a document that has all the articles of our faith as Christians, as Catholic Christians. It explains all the sacraments, it explains all the articles contained in the creed, and many, many other things that we want to know about the Catholic faith. So please read this document for you to understand better your faith, the Catholic faith. Two, the general instructions of the Roman Missal. This is a very small document that you can read within 2 weeks if you are very serious. It's a document that looks specifically at the particulars of Mass. It explains all the stages of Mass, all the practices in Mass, and everything else that surrounds Mass. There are a few passages here and there that talk about the paraliturgies, you know, those other liturgies that we have outside Mass. But it is basically a document that explains Mass and everything else that has to do with Mass. This is something that you want to have in your house and to read every day for you to understand what you do and why you do it in Mass. Okay? Three, the Code of Canon Law. The Code of Canon Law is like our constitution. It is the constitution of the Church. It presents to you the legal part of the Church. It explains all the sacraments from the legal point of view. It explains issues to do with the temporal goods of the Church. It explains the hierarchy of the Church. It gives you norms, regulations, and everything else that governs the Church. This is another document that you want to have and to read always. Of course, you're going to come across many passages or paragraphs or articles in these books that probably might not be very clear to you, maybe because they are too philosophical or they are too theological. Please feel free to approach any seminarian, any deacon, any priest. Ask them questions for you to understand these things. Okay, so please be inquisitive, be curious, go and ask questions for you to learn and appreciate more your Catholic faith. So thank you very much for your time, and please, if you have not yet subscribed to my channel, click that button over there and subscribe so that whenever I post a new video, you don't miss out, you always receive a notification. Thank you so much once again, and may God bless you abundantly.